Howdy class, Dr. J with you. I am, as you're likely aware by now from checking out a couple of my videos, I'm on the Real World Climate Change Tour, and I've stopped off in Thailand. I was in Bangkok for a little while, and I took the train up to Chiang Mai, arrived in Chiang Mai a day or so ago. It's in northern Thailand, and I'm here for the rest of the day and headed off to Laos tomorrow. But thinking about you guys and hope that you're enjoying the class, but wanted to chat a little bit more because it's on my mind a little bit more about direct versus indirect insolation, incoming solar radiation. Again, that is not insolation, not the pink stuff that you put up in your attic, but insolation, incoming solar radiation. It really determines how hot a place is going to be. And as I'm in Chiang Mai, Thailand, it's hot. It's actually not all that bad because it's not that humid today. But yeah, it really is all about the direct rays of the sun. And as you know, the direct rays of the sun, and those are beams of sunlight that strike the earth in a perpendicular fashion, in a 90 degree fashion, the direct beams of sunlight only get as far as 23 north or as far as 23 south. So Chiang Mai is, I think, about 13 degrees north latitude. It's May 13. So the direct rays of the sun, and we call that the spot that's receiving direct sunlight on any given day, we refer to that as the declination of the sun. In any case, the declination of the sun, or the spot on the earth that's getting the direct rays of the sun, pretty darn close to Chiang Mai's latitude. And so let me just go ahead and pan up. So that's the horizon over there, and I've got to show you this scene because I got out of the city a little bit, not that far out of the city. Maybe you can see some of the mountains in the background. This isn't a lake, and this is pretty much sort of like a campground area for the folks in Chiang Mai to escape for the weekend. It's Sunday. But anyway, so that's the local horizon, right? And as I'm panning up, there you go. I don't want to blind you, right? But that's where the sun is overhead. So it's not quite at 90 degrees, but it's getting there. And so that sunlight is really intense. And you know, that sunlight is passing down through the gases in the atmosphere. And Janelle, let me just pan around so you don't have to look at my ugly face the whole time. Anyway, so as you know, the gases in the atmosphere are for the most part transparent to shortwave radiation from the sun. So that strong sunlight, right? It's very strong sunlight, gets down to the surface of the earth. It's absorbed by the surface of the earth. And by the way, man-made materials like this asphalt versus natural surfaces like this grass over here, the asphalt absorbs that sunlight really well. And then, as you know, right, that the earth's surface then transmits that, or emits that, radiates that energy back up in the atmosphere. So it's really the surface of the earth that is heating the atmosphere, but just sort of indirectly, because the ultimate energy source is from the sun. Right, but that sunlight, that shortwave radiation, makes its way to the surface of the earth, for the most part unimpeded. We'll go ahead and fine tune that idea a little bit later on, where it's absorbed at the surface of the earth, and then the surface of the earth actually heats the atmosphere. And that is why, and this was another big important point, that is why the atmosphere in the lowest most layer, which is called what? The troposphere. There you go. That is why the troposphere gets colder with height, because the heat source is really the ground. And as you get farther away from the ground, it gets cooler. Now, you know, up in the stratosphere, everything reverses because you got ozone up there that absorbs some shortwave radiation. And then the thermosphere gets colder with height again. And then, up in the mesosphere, it gets colder with height again. And then the thermosphere gets warmer with height because oxygen up in the thermosphere, because that sunlight is so strong, absorbs that very strong sunlight. So just to sort of recap, it's all about incoming solar radiation, really. And remember, the lowest most layer of the atmosphere gets heated from the ground on up, right? So it gets colder with height on average in the troposphere, warmer in the stratosphere because of the absorption of ozone, colder in the mesosphere because there are no gases that absorb sunlight there, and then in the thermosphere, it gets warmer with height because oxygen is absorbed by that very strong sunlight. Okay, that went on a little bit longer, but now let me go ahead and show you what I'm getting to enjoy right now. And oh my God, check out this precious little guy right here. The kids, oh my God, little Thai child, just amazing. Oh, he's so sweet. Noisy traffic in the background, but this is really cool. So this is it's a resort, a campground, and rather than having picnic tables, right, like we have in our campgrounds back in the States, so they have these little huts with thatched roofs, and they ring the lake, and of course the water is cooler than the land, so it's a little cooler sitting on the lake, right, and they're getting shade, and these are picnic spots for the folks here. And you can see the temples ring the entire lake almost, and you got the mountains in the background. This is just a spectacular spot. Okay, that's enough. I'm in northern Thailand, having a blast and learning a whole lot. Hope you learn a lot in class.